So throughout this semester, obviously talking about leadership, organizational behavior, you saw in my journals and my written assessments, I talked a lot about basketball and how that's kind of impacted my life and how I've learned different coaches and leaderships in that aspect. So what I'll talk about for this video is one of my coaches at Arkansas State. His name was Grant McCaslin. He came in my junior year, brand new. Our coach just got fired. He came in, brought a whole new kind of culture to the program, and I really just loved the kind of person he was, how he led us, how he coached us, and how he treated us on and off the court. So just describing him and some of the stuff we talked about in the journal with courage. I mean, he came from Baylor in 2015, and I know that's a really high major school coming to Arkansas State, but it was his first head coaching job at that Division I level. And the courage it took for him to uproot his family and just transition his pretty much his entire life to a new school, to people that he had no idea. Texas to Arkansas is just different. And obviously with our AD, with our other coaches of different sports, he had to really introduce his family to a completely new crowd of people. An example of that, one of the first things he did with us, and this is also gaining respect by building trust. The first day he got his job, I think there was five of us still on the team, like seniors graduating, guys didn't want to come back, wanted to transfer, blah, blah, blah. One of the first things he did is he sat all four of us down in a room and just really talked about, hey, I know you guys don't know me, I don't know you, but I'm going to respect you. I'm gonna push you to be better, but at the same time, you're going to be disciplined, you're going to be punished for doing stuff the wrong way. And he really just wanted us, he knew we wouldn't trust him right away, but he tried building that trust right off the bat by trying to get our respect. We ended up going that season, breaking the single season record for wins. He was a great coach. One of the other things that was great about him was his religion, his faith in Christ, and that kind of going along with the servant leader that we talked about in one of our journals is he just knew that he could be a better leader by helping others. If he wouldn't make, for example, he wouldn't make like the managers just bring us water bottles day in and day out during practice. He might bring it up one time. He'll do something with the video coordinators, the assistant coaches. He didn't just put it all on anyone else. He was a servant leader to them. He wanted to show them that even though he was the head coach, he wanted to have that aspect of trust and that relationship with the people around him. He valued us as players. I know a lot of coaches will say that, but he really cared about, with me personally, he cared about my faith, and he would invite me to go to church with him and his family. I was 10, 11 hours away from home. He would invite me to go to church with him. He'd invite the whole team. And really kind of poured into us faith and just being good to others, being good people, being Christ-like followers. So another one, he embraced his true self. He didn't let the change of culture from Texas to Arkansas affect his emotions. He didn't let going from an assistant coach to a head coach, he didn't let that change who he was. He stayed true to himself. And when I saw this assignment and describing a leader, he was the first one that popped into my head. And I mean, obviously there's gonna be negatives and positives any leader. After that 20-win season, he got a new job at a higher level school after just 1 year, and he took that, so we had to get another coach. But just off the bat, he was so easy to talk about because I really connected with him on the basketball court, off the basketball court. And as you know, the whole semester I've talked about basketball and different leaders and different coaching styles in that aspect. So this class has definitely helped me with that. It's definitely made me look at my past coaches and relationships on another level. I could see the positives, I could see the negatives, what they did for me or what they didn't do for me. I kind of fed off of that, and this class has really helped me, like, to show me what I should do if I got into coaching one day, what I shouldn't do. And it's not just coaching, it's leaders managing others. If I was a boss of even a law firm, I know that's not something I want to do, but knowing how to treat others well and how to be a more efficient leader. This class has really helped me with that. And just moving forward, I'm definitely gonna take just the characteristics of the principal leadership that we've gotten in this class, going over the journal. And that's something I really liked about the class, was being able to show my opinions and going into my past and just learning more about me. And I really enjoyed this class, and I just want to thank you for teaching us.